Well, kind of crazy, you know, and I would say ridiculous, really. Very frustrating, to say the least. I've got a patient that I've been just recently was referred to me, and she's in her, I guess, mid-30s, and very, very sick. She's been sick for about 19 months now, and she's, main thing is just no energy. She has diffuse achy muscle pain all over, a lot of the typical fibro stuff, but she just has no energy. She's lost her job. She's got kids that, you know, small kids that she can't take care of. She can barely make it out of bed. A lot of days she didn't get out of bed. She makes it to, you know, a lot, she'll make it to the couch, and that's kind of about it. I mean, she just has no energy, and it's been this way for 19 months. Now, what's interesting in my new patient consult is I always try to do a little detective work and figure out what was the causes of these different symptoms. So I'm trying to figure out, you know, what caused this fatigue. So I asked her, you know, prior to this, you know, 19 months ago, were you in good health? She said, yeah. You know, I was pretty healthy. I wasn't the healthiest person, but I was doing pretty good. I certainly wasn't where I couldn't work. I couldn't take care of my kids. I had some energy. And I said, well, you know, okay, well, 19 months ago, what happened? She said, well, I had mono. And of course, the bells start going off, mono. Okay, well, mono. Epstein-Barr virus can, I mean, when you get a bad case of that, it can really, really take it out of you. And one of the number one things with that is, you know, like the flu or any bad infection, is fatigue. So I asked her, okay, well, so you went to your doctor, did they test you for it? They tested me for it. They said it was positive. And they said, you know, that I'll get over it and, you know, it'll run its course. And, but, you know, I've never felt good. Right around that time, when I started getting really run down. I said, well, you've been back to your doctor? Have they retested it? Did they put you on an antiviral like Valtrex or Acyclovir? She said no. And I said, well, you know, I do everything naturally. I have for 20 years, ever since I sold my medical practice. I try to do everything naturally, but there's a time and a place, and I'm a realist, and you need to be on antivirals. I bet you anything, you've still got active Epstein-Barr virus, and you are have all these symptoms because of that. Let's retest you and let's see what we find. Well, so I do some detective work, do some specialized testing. I find that not only does she have active Epstein-Barr virus, meaning her antibodies are still elevated, the IgM antibodies, which shows that the virus is still active in her system. She also has low vitamin D that can cause low energy. She also has anemia, which has never been picked up. So she has a low ferritin level, low iron saturation, total iron is low. Now, hemoglobin, hematocrit, some of these other things are low normal. So her doctor's always telling her that they're normal and that's, you know, no problem. Well, it was the perfect storm came, you know, because she has a heavy menstrual cycle. So, okay, she's prone to being anemic. And so that's part of it. She has low vitamin D. So that's another thing, low energy. And then she's got this active Epstein-Barr virus where she needs to be on antivirals, as well as some natural things that I recommended to knock that virus out. Okay, well, I said, you know, you got to go back to your doctor. So she goes back. Now, she's been to the doctor twice in the 19-month period, and they've done nothing for her. And she says, hey, I'm working with this doctor, and he says that I've got active Epstein-Barr virus. I need to be taking Acyclovir or Valtrex, whichever you recommend. And she looks at her, and she, you know, looks at my patient. She says, you know, who is this that says this? This says a Dr. Murphree, and who is this? He's a chiropractor? He's not even a real doctor. And then so my patient immediately started taking up for me and said, well, you know what? He's the first doctor that's been able to explain to me what's going on. I feel better just in the 2 weeks I started the natural stuff. The 2 weeks it's taken to get in to see you, by the way, that I'm coming in here to get these antivirals. He recommends that I take these prescription antiviral medications to start attacking the virus, the Epstein-Barr virus. And she reluctantly, you know, after she browbeat her and basically did everything but call me a quack, told her that, you know, she would write a prescription for these antivirals. And, you know, she didn't understand why she was working with somebody via phone in another state that's not a real doctor, but she would go along with it. Well, you know, the truth is the truth. It doesn't matter where it comes from. And right is right, and wrong is wrong. Let's face it, this doctor had done nothing for this patient and would not have done anything for this patient had I not done the right testing to find the underlying causes of her low energy. This happens all the time. There's doctors out there who don't understand fibromyalgia. They don't understand why they need to do thorough testing to find what is the cause, plural, causes of your different symptoms. Whether it's the cause of your pain, the cause of your low energy, the cause of your low moods, the cause of your IBS. Testing can show where you're broken down. A lot of doctors, because they just don't understand fibromyalgia, some don't even believe it's real, they don't do the detective work. And when that doesn't happen, then you fall through the cracks. You get missed. You just become another medical misfit. So I encourage you to make sure that you're tenacious, you're aggressive enough to make sure your doctor is doing thorough testing, okay? And if you're not getting the answers from your doctor that you need, I encourage you to find another doctor. I would personally love to help you any way that I can. I encourage you to learn more about the different options of working with me and all the free resources available to you at YourFibroDoctor.com. This is Dr. Rodger Murphree, YourFibroDoctor.com, author of Treating and Beating Fibromyalgia Chronic Fatigue Syndrome. Don't let any doctor ignore you. Make them help you or get another doctor.